Now I also use the Daffodil Delight 1/4 inch grow grain ribbon for this card, and I'll show you how I made the bow. Find the middle, and you'll want to put some tape in the middle. This bow is very sticky, and I call it a corsage bow because all the loops and the tails are on one side like a corsage. Fold that over like you're making a fake bow, and a little more tape, some real long streamers there, lots of sticky tape. Now essentially I'm taking this bow that's rather flat in the middle and I'm folding it over. I'm going to use some more tape. And I'm going to put this tail over here with this one so they will show up in the middle. A little more tape. We don't care what it looks like in the middle. That part's going to be covered up. And I'm going to fold this one over. So now you have two loops and the tails. We'll trim those to pretty good length there. And it's ready to go on our card. On the card, I've used the die from Stamping Up. That's the circle die. It's about 4 inches. And for the black mat, and I used for the white mat, and for the black one, I used the die that's the scallop die. I put this line across it right here so that I can lay my paper right on there and not have to trim it after I've run it through the Big Shot. The rest of the card, I stamped the beehive with stays on and sponged it with yellow Daffodil Delight. The bees have been embossed with black and colored with a marker. The pattern paper is Patterns designer paper, and of course the 1/4 inch grow grain ribbon that matches the bow. A sponged blue for the sky, and we're ready to assemble. Put some more tape on the bow, and I think I'll point it down this way. Makes sure it's securely on the card. You can lift this up and put some more tape under there. And we'll peel off our backing to this. And we'll add our embellishment. And there you have it.